The FB4 Settings window can be found under File, FB4 Settings. The FB4 Settings window is a virtual terminal to change settings on your FB4s, like RDM. Everything you can control on screen of the FB4 can be changed and controlled from this window. You can also see FB4s in this window that are on the network, but not on Beyond/QS mode. This is great for troubleshooting projectors that are already hung and in the air. On the top, we can refresh our list to see what projectors are on the network and label them if we would like. Under View, we can change how our lists look, and under Quick, we can quickly change modes in all the projectors on the network. On the right, we can change all settings for the projectors, first with the mode and all of the settings. To adjust settings, select which FB4 you want to change, or multiple FB4s, in the list. First, we can select the operational mode we want our FB4s to be in. Note, not all FB4s will have all options. It will depend on what hardware they are equipped with. On the right, we can adjust the other settings. First, our IP settings. We can see here the device's current IP mode, its IP, and its subnet mask. If we want to assign a static IP for this FB4, we can type in the fixed IP mask and click fixed IP. Note that if you're unaware of your network's IP settings, it is best to leave them in auto IP mode until you know your IP settings will work. And you don't want to lose access to the device over the network. You don't want to have to go up to the projector to change its IP if it's already hung in the air. Under our master settings, we have control of the FB4's max brightness, its size, and hardware inverts of the X and Y positions. Under color, we have access to our projector color shift and the max brightness level of each FB4 color channel. Under that, we have access to our DMX fixture profile slash mode of the 16-channel mode or the 39-channel mode for DMX or Artnet control. Next, we have Artnet settings for your universe and subnet. Then, the fixture channel start. We can enable RDM in the preamble. If you're using DMX instead of Artnet, you can set your channel, RDM, and preamble here. Now let's look at settings related to autoplay features. First, we can select our basic autoplay mode for playing a queue or a list and which index that is. Then we can decide when the queue stops to either stop, loop, or hold. If you have a battery installed in your FB4, it can keep time. Here you can set all the date and time for the FB4 manually or sync to the PC that it's connected to. You can also sync all FB4s with this button. Now let's move on to overall geometric correction for size X and Y, position X and Y, rotation, and shear. These settings are the same settings that will change when you use your setup profile on the 39-channel DMX/Artnet mode. Under timecode, we can select things related to content that has been uploaded and running off of Artnet timecode. The file index, and any offsets you need to keep everything in time. Lastly, we have our scan guard. This is a virtual scan guard, which will act similarly to pass our safety scanning system. This will keep hoppings from becoming too hot and thus dangerous within your specified area. Horizon level and angle is setting where you can set how high up your guard area will be and if you want it to be an angle around. Min velocity is how slow the scanner's movement need to be to trigger the safety. And dwell time is how long a scanner needs to stay in one place to trigger the safety. You can invert the Y and how long it'll take before the laser turns back on. Thank you for watching our Quick Hints video on the FB4 settings window inside of QuickShow. If you still need help, you can contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com and we'll help you as soon as we can.